Thank you, Professor Rogge, for the nice introduction and the welcome. I would also like to welcome you here in Berlin at BAM. I'm very happy that we have all made it here. And it's a little bit of closing the circle. We are at a location where it started. And I would like to refer to the submission of the proposal for this cost action in 2013. This was still here at BAM, where I was still here, mainly employed in BAM, before I then also started to work at the Technical University of Denmark. And the topic somehow came out of as one part of the PhD thesis I was writing here at BAM, which I later defended then at ETH Zurich. Of course, this was only one building stone. It very much goes back to the awareness of the scientific community of the methods of for quantifying the value of information and the Bayesian decision theory. So with the PhD thesis, this was a starting point, which then could be and was further developed so that we had an approach for this cost action. Yeah, well, I defended at the 3rd of March 2011, the PhD thesis. And we all have experienced and know from history that ideas somehow came or come up at different locations with people working independently, and this was also the case here. So Matteo Pozzi and Armin der Kuregian published 4 days later, sorry, for for being picky about the dates. This can also be debated, but a very similar approach for the quantification of the value of information for structural health monitoring. We have strived to improve the decision basis in a broader context for the design and operation and life, in the end, life cycle integrity management of infrastructures, with a focus on quantifying the value of structural health monitoring using the most powerful tools we have, the Bayesian pre-posterior decision analysis, to assess the value of information before it is implemented, before any information strategy, information acquirement strategy is implemented, and before we implement any measures. We were happy to receive the funding for this project by COST. We started late 2014. We have got an extension, so it's it has become a 4.5 years project with a temporal extension, but also a budget extension. So this action is very well appreciated by COST. And we had a very critical and significant contribution here of the Joint Committee on Structural Safety, especially in the starting phase and continuously later by contributions to this topic. Many of the Joint Committee of Structural Safety members are also members of this cost action. I should also say contributing members of this cost action. We have formed over the last years a network comprising around 130 participants from 29 European countries, researchers mainly, but this is very critical for us that we also have in this network engineering consultants, representatives from industrial enterprises and also representatives from infrastructure operators and authorities. Such a network is difficult to handle, to my experience, but it has been a challenge, but it was also a great pleasure to work with many, very, very many of you, always trying to adjust to the individual working styles. Some are used to work in large projects, some are working primarily individually, achieving significant research results. So, and then there's of course different mentalities around Europe. So yeah, this was difficult, but it was also a pleasure to do. We have anchored the network of the Cost Action internationally, mainly with the professors on the right side, Mark Stewart from University of Newcastle, Australia, Professor Dagang Lu, Harbin Institute of Technology, China, Michael Todd, University of California, San Diego, US. These are the three we have been working in the later phase very closely with. In the beginning, we had support from James Beck, Professor James Beck from California Institute of Technology, US, and Armin der Koregian. So what did we do? This is a map of activities we have been doing across our network. We have workshop locations in, we have here a training school location, Cadenabia, and here's another training school location, Trogir, from last year. And yeah, but a little more numbers on what we did. So by the number of the dots, you may have noticed the order of the workshops. We had so far 16 workshops and conferences. Two smaller ones are to come. We have organized training schools, two training schools from the point of view now. This was too few training schools. Surely there's lessons learned here from us. We have also lessons learned, so training school activities, I think, is something which really needs to be continued and even intensified. We will have, or we will reach around 21 or 22 scientific missions. So this was the most or the best tool for activating research resources. When some researcher went to another country, to an institution, to work on a specific topic there. We have been organizing, we have been organizing special sessions in conferences, mainly in Europe, but also there will be one in Asia. We have been to Canada. This was actually the first special session we organized. It was a small session. It may have been five papers. This has changed significantly here throughout the years, and especially in 2018, we have been organizing four special sessions, all well attended, with significantly more papers than five, as we had in the beginning. We are preparing special journal issues. There's one out, two are actually in the process, and one is in preparation for the structural safety. This is in preparation. We hope that we will also have this one. In preparation is an engineering structures special issue focusing on the case studies and structural health monitoring special issue with the anchor in the structural health monitoring community. And actually the idea here of the structural safety is that there is an anchor in the community of the structural risk and reliability analysis community. We had a production of 60 plus conference and journal publication. This will significantly increase with the special issues we are preparing. And yes, there's much more activities, and we tried to document many of our activities, especially of the workshops with audio and video recording, with the presentations and with workshop reports for the larger workshops. So to give an introduction to the coming presentations, I would like to point at achievements which I find particularly important. And the first one is that we have provided the scientific evidence of tremendous economic life safety benefits due to the utilization of SHM. We have found this in the literature review. Until 2001, there it was stated, but it was not quantified. We have done. And we have done this on different levels with the framework, with models, methods, tools for the quantification of the value of structural health monitoring, with case studies, even here with guides, with a guide for scientists, where we summarize the framework we have been developing and give also an example for the utilization of the methods and tools and basically the main outcomes of this cost action. So you will hear much more and in much in a more comprehensive way in the next presentation throughout the day. And we have, I think this is the third point, also very important, we have prepared the industrial utilization of value of SHM analysis with the case studies, a case study portfolio we have, and further guides for practicing engineers and for infrastructure operators to be issued also in the Joint Committee on Structural Safety as part of their guidelines and documents. But there's something even more important I'm very proud of. And for this, I would like to go back to a slide from the first workshop in May 2015 in Copenhagen, where I cited Henry Ford. So, well, in 2015, May 2015, we have come together. We had a tool of keeping together. But for me, the most important thing is we have really worked in these four and a half years. Thank you very much.